tears, little blue hues like tears for fears. Your love, no, I can't get enough. Losing my cool, but I'm staying alive. Dancing the ranks to kiss the night at your touch. Oh, it feels like a glove. Oh, don't need drama. I just need one word to get to you. So tell me now, do you want it? Cause these dancing feet don't cry to the rhythm it got for you. And every Saturday night that you ain't keep my tears blue. And these burning lights, they shine so bright like we're on the moon. I don't wanna dance on the beach, no, unless it's with you. Can't you
hi, Andrew. I'm not going to be afraid. Well, maybe a little bit to show the world how much I care for you, how much I appreciate you, and just how much I love you.
Some of you may not know this, but Jod, when we first dated, really hated sharing food. Now I just inhale all the leftovers and like the endless abyss that I am. It's a symbol of how you gave your all to me, how you trusted me, how you let down all your walls and really took me in.
From day one, you showed me your love in every way, from the things you say to the things you do in front of our friends.
So one thing I remember so vividly was when I was abroad and you came to visit me, and it was the happiest moment of my life.
You're always there, whether there was an exam or not. Heck, you were studying for your shelf exam while you were in the Pittsburgh ER with me, and you had an exam in Florida the next day.
And then suddenly I remember the feeling of you having to leave, and that tore me apart. That was such a hard thing to go through. And that visceral sadness was really just another reminder of how much I cared for you and how much I really loved you.
We may not know where we'll end up in the next few years, but as you've shown me over the last 4 years, location is never going to be a problem. Your sacrifices have not been overlooked, and I want everyone here to know just how good of a man you are. You're the smartest, most patient, kind-hearted, intentional, and most attractive man, human being on this earth. My family is the most important thing to me, and I love that you love my family. I think at the beginning, my parents were afraid of me getting hurt, but now they're protective over you. That's how I know they love you, and you have surpassed my dreams of what I wanted my partner to be with my family.
And for me, I grew up and I didn't always express my emotions. And I feel like for me, that having that by my side and having you teach me how to be better about my emotions has made me such a more better person, a stronger person, and a better companion to you.
I promise from now on to say I love you every night. I promise to try to learn to cook and do the laundry. I promise to respect you and give you the time and effort you need from me.
No matter what we go through, no matter the hardship, no matter where we end up, I'll never stop chasing you. I'll never stop improving myself to be better for you. I'll never withhold my heart. I'll never hold in those feelings. And I'll never run away.
Lastly, we're constantly changing as people with our values and beliefs. But I promise to grow with you and to ride the ebb and flow. I love you most.
You're the love of my life. You are my literal queen. And finally, I've caught my fish. It can be us, just us, and the rest of the world falls away.
We're gonna have you guys exchange rings and still kiss in front of everyone. Okay. Now, if the photographer is ready, I will get out of the shot. And Andrew, you may kiss Jod. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Prado Wang!
This love has no ceiling. For those who don't know me, I'm Sagar, best man, and one of Andrew's roommates from NYU.
Hi everyone, I'm Sharisha.
I'm Priya.
And we're both co-maids of honor.
My name is Marvin, I'm Jod's father.
Thank you very much. It is my honor to welcome all of you to Jod and Andrew's wedding ceremony.
Actually, I've known Andrew and Jod since college, so I've been fortunate enough to watch their relationship grow from the very beginning and see them grow together as one.
We all grew up in a tiny little town called New Providence, New Jersey. Jod, Trisha, and I knew each other for a pretty long time, but we didn't really become close until high school.
Before Andrew met Jod, he had just a couple of priorities. You guys can probably guess them. He's not very sophisticated. It's a very short list. The first one is food. The second one is Halo, the video game.
Jod and I decided that we wanted to be closer with Trisha. And as any normal person would do, we just started showing up to Trisha's house unannounced.
They would just be there all the time. And another, I guess, story kind of related is, so the night of our prom, Jod, Priya, and a couple of our other friends were going to come over to my house and stay for that night, like just as a sleepover, and Jod came with a fully packed carry-on suitcase. And that is how she told me she would be staying the entire weekend and like moving into the guest bedroom. Not a usual tactic. I've never had a friend do that before, but clearly an effective one because it's been over 10 years and we're still friends. So we got really close in high school. We stayed super close throughout high school, and then we all kind of went our separate ways to college. So I was in California, Jod was in New York, Priya was in Connecticut. And when Jod went to college, she was super mission-driven. Her one goal, which I think is still to this day, was to be a doctor. When she left, she was like, no, nothing will distract me from this goal. No boys. No partying. Absolutely nothing will prevent me from being a doctor. And we were like, amazing. And things are going great. She's doing great at school. She joins this med frat. Things are going great there. And then we kind of start hearing, like, you know, words here and there about this guy named Andrew. Andrew's like at the study sessions, in the library, always talking to her. We're kind of like, does Andrew like you maybe? Jod's like, no. He is just a friend. Don't get it twisted. We're just friends. We'll all get here.
Andrew used to spend a lot of time playing video games with the boys. That was all before he met Jod, of course. After he met Jod, we noticed he would skip out on game night a lot more often. And that's like basically unheard of from Andrew. That's his one true love. And then after he met Jod, the tradition transitioned into weekly trips to Mitu, our halal cart guy in the city. And, of course, it now included a stop at Vivi's for bubble tea for Jod as well.
As much as Jod tried to say that they were just friends, quite soon after Jod, you know, unsurprisingly told us that she and Andrew were dating, and Trisha and I, you know, had to act very surprised, like, oh my god, no way, it's looks so crazy.
Well, it turns out a group of friends actually had a name for this homogenous blob. And that name, you guys have heard it, you can say it with me, is Androd. Androd, right? And of course, Jod was so worth it. But we just didn't know it yet. Andrew did. You see, Andrew already knew he was going to marry Jod. In fact, he already told me so just a few days into their relationship.
Queen, I used to say, I love you. You know that, you know? Every time you talk on the phone, I would say, I love you. But there's only one thing that I can tell you. But I'm proud of you for choosing the right and perfect husband.
Andrew, we literally always tell Jod this, that she struck a home run her first time at bat. We tell her all the time, Andrew is the most amazing man. He's so kind. He was so persistent even when she invited us on your dates and Skype calls. Like, thank you for sticking it out. And yeah, we love you. We love how much you love Jod, and it's so evident how much you care for her.
And Andrew, the first day I met you, you helped us brought the grocery all the way to 6th floor. And I said to myself, I know one day, one of these people is gonna be the future husband of my daughter. And then, I was damn right. The night that you asked permission from me to marry Queen, I was very happy.
It's been really beautiful seeing your friendship, your relationship, oh my god. Relationship, your friendship and then your relationship blossom and develop. I feel like we've seen each other grow through some pretty formative years and some pretty tough points. And just seeing how you both have really stuck it through really like tough points and worked it through is just really beautiful. And yeah, we're so excited for you both and for this new chapter in your life.
They're gonna be good days and sad days, but always remember, respect each other. Respect is the cornerstone of every successful relationship. Before you talk, you listen. Because when you talk, you are just repeating of what you already know. But when you listen, you learn something new. And lastly, I wish you good health and happiness for the rest of your life.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate that, and I think hope this will be an enjoyable event for all of you.
So I guess if everyone could raise their glass, if they have one, and just raise a toast to Jod and Andrew.
And I just want to say congrats to Andrew. I'm not afraid of the dark.